Hello, hello, Roswitha. How are you? Thank you for accepting my invitation to be on my spiritual show. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. I'm so excited to do this and to have the pleasure of being interviewed by an awesome client of mine that, you know, we've worked together for so long. I think the first time was like 2017, 2018. I don't even remember.
Exactly, 2017. The start of the adventure.
Yeah, so we've known each other for a long time. So it's such a pleasure to see you, how much you've grown and having your own show now. So it's really fun to be here. Thank you.
You know, my idea of this spiritual show was to have people who walk the talk, people who use manifesting every day, people who use manifesting to attract their dream life. And I never had the subject before on my vlog about mm-hmm. how to use manifesting when it comes to business. And I'm sure this mm-hmm. is something that a lot of people are super interested to find out how to make things smoother, things easier, because we live so much in this hustle culture, do this, do that. And I want to show people that they can do things much easier and much faster, which with less stress. So this mm-hmm. is one of the most important things, and I'm super excited to talk about this. And I would like you first to let me introduce you actually a little bit, because I know you come from an engineering student and now you are a manifesting coach, and it's a little bit of a contradiction when you think about it.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I'm gonna try to make it as short as possible because my life has been so, let's say, so big in terms of how many changes I've made in just a short period of time. So I graduated power engineering as a straight A student. During that time, I was also a fashion blogger, fashion and beauty blogger with my boyfriend and husband now. We owned a couple of websites for men, for women. We've done blogging. This was in the beginning stages of blogging, the beginning era of influencers when, you know, there were no Instagram back then. There was like nothing like this. And so I've learned a lot about online business as I was in college. And then we went to Fashion Week, New York Fashion Week, front row seat. It was like the best experience for a 20-year-old to have, especially me from Romania, from not a glamorous, you know, background. I couldn't even imagine myself going to New York, you know, as I was watching Sex and the City, you know, in high school. And I was like, oh my God, I want to be Carrie, you know, like walking the streets of New York and be super fashionable, not to mention going to fashion shows. Like, you know, that was such a huge dream from a girl from such a, you know, from Romania, from not something glamorous. And then in 2014, I was actually able to do that. So I manifested the exact experience a couple of years earlier I desired for myself. So of course, everything is possible. And I knew I could manifest stuff. So after I graduated, during that time, I did a lot of entrepreneurship courses and mentoring and therapy to see what I really want to do with my life, because blogging fashion was exciting and was fun, but I felt it was not my purpose. It was just something I was good at and I was doing just because I wanted to fulfill a desire, which I already did. So after I did that, I was like, what else is here? You know, I've accomplished my biggest dream. So what's the next thing? And I couldn't find a next thing to motivate me to stay in the fashion industry longer. So then I decided that the best path for me would be to be a coach. This after, you know, so many tests of, you know, what are you good at and all those things, because again, back then that was a thing, you know, you would go to therapy and they would test you, you know, like, what are you good at and what can you do and what are your aptitudes and all those things. So everything kind of gave me the same result. I should work with people in a coaching or a therapy environment. I didn't want to become a therapist. I didn't want to work with that kind of clients. I wanted to empower. Like, coaching takes you from, coaching is already working with people who are good at something or who are in a good state and gets them excellent. As for therapy works best for people who have some sort of, now I want to say broken people, they're not broken, but they have some sort of trauma. They have some sort of situation that they need to overcome. So therapy there works best, but not for me. That was not something that I wanted to solve or to help people with. So I just graduated. I still remember this. I gave my first, like my last exam and everything on Friday. Saturday morning, like 6 a.m., I was on the flight to New York and I had no idea if I would come back, because I was like, there's nothing here for me. Like, I don't want to go to master's. I don't want to become an engineer. I don't want to get a job. I don't know what I want. I know that this is definitely not something that I want. So I'm just going to go to US again, and I will, I don't know. I kept on asking God and the universe to help me, to guide me. I remember telling my mom when I left that I have no idea what's going to happen this summer, but I will find my path. It's just that I don't know what that is yet. And of course, a couple of months later, I was already joining a school to become a coach, a certified coach. And that's how 6 years ago, my coaching, let's say, whole journey started. I was an integrative holistic coach. That was what I went for. And in these 6 years, I've kind of realized that what I was able to help people with, besides learning how to use their mind and their energy, this was before I knew what manifesting truly is. It was just like, you know, everybody who kind of reads a couple of self-development books or sees The Secret is like, oh, I know what manifesting is.
You start to feel it a little bit.
Yeah, but I'm like, no, you don't. Like manifesting is, I mean, I've applied manifesting and taught manifesting for years before actually knowing what manifesting truly is, which I've just learned in the past year. So I know everybody feels like, oh my God, I know it's about positive thinking. I know it's about, you know, journaling, or it's about meditation, but it's so much more complex and bigger than that. And that's why manifesting doesn't work for so many people. You know, they like, it works for certain goals, but not all goals. And I'm sure it happened to you too, you know, when you have certain goals and they manifest so fast and so beautifully, and you're like, fuck, I'm so good at manifesting. And then you do the same thing for other goals and nothing happens. And you're like, what's going on? Like, what am I missing? Why is it not working out for me? So you doubt yourself, you doubt the whole process. Maybe manifesting is stupid or doesn't work out. Maybe just a placebo effect. So that's why now I really know what manifesting is and how to teach it properly, because I can pinpoint and show people that, okay, this is why this goal specifically didn't manifest for you. And you know, once you have that clarity, then of course you also have the solutions to what can you change or what can you do to make it work, if it makes sense.
Yeah, it makes sense. That is absolutely amazing. Like, when you think about, and I think this is actually the first thing that brought my attention to you when I started following you a couple of years ago, that you came from Romania, which is an Eastern European country, super small country, and with not the best mindset. And you ended up being a coach and starting a school in New York and having your own fashion blog, which for me was amazing at that time and still is. And I'm sure it's one of, it's a dream actually that a lot of girls have to make it big in their life. Is this how you came up in the end with the Manifesting Queen course? How this idea started to form?
Such a good question. So, as I said, I knew manifesting. I was already teaching that and getting results with people and with my own life. But there came a point where I got stuck. So my whole life as a business owner, because I've been a business owner for almost 11 years now. So that's a long time to be in business and try different online businesses. I thought that I will be able to scale my business. So to reach $10,000 a month. So that's what I'm saying, 10K a month on autopilot every single month, like clockwise, if I have a team, if I have a lot of money to invest in advertising, if I have this amazing funnel, you know, like a marketing funnel where you know, it's all this perfect marketing strategy. So for years, I worked on getting there, you know, on having the money to hire the team, on knowing how to create my marketing funnel, all this aspect of business that everybody told me that, hey, if you have this, then you can easily get 10K. So I had it after like 4 years of getting there. I had that. I had the money. I had everything that I needed, like down to a T. I had everything, and it didn't fucking work. Like not that it didn't work. So you have to understand the big disappointment. I was launching before that. I had courses before that. I made money, a lot of money before that. I could make 10K per launch before having all this. So I knew I could do it. It was not like I'm just hoping, you know, that this will save me. No, I knew I could make the money. I just hope that now with so much help, I'm going to make money look like this, you know, like.
Yeah, much faster.
And much faster and much easier and much, I don't know, everything should have been super, super awesome. And it wasn't. Like, we didn't even manage, like, our ads didn't work. Our nothing worked. And I was like, even my relationship with between me and my team, like the experts that I hired was all wanky. And just, it was just like 3 months of super pain in my life because we worked for 3 months. It was not just like we try for 2 weeks, it doesn't work. Okay. No, it was a 3 month commitment. It was $10,000, no, more than $10,000 investment for 3 months. And we had zero sales. We had 13 subscribers, 13. Can you imagine? Like, I would get like at least 500 per launch. Yeah, and I had 13 in 3 freaking months. And I worked like crazy because they would keep on telling me, oh, you need to change this sales page. Oh, you need to change this freebie. Oh, you need to change this thing. Oh, you need to change. And I was like always changing. And so it was a complete failure. After that, I felt so disappointed in myself, in the whole universe. I was like, dude, my whole life, this is what the gurus, the marketing people told me, that if I have this, I will achieve this. I had this, I didn't achieve this. Like, what the fuck? What's going on? What's not working out? So then I actually understood after a couple of months, it didn't happen instantly. And this is something that I think people need to know. Change does not happen instantly. You can have a breakthrough instantly, but to incorporate that breakthrough into your life and actually live it, it takes weeks and months. So this is why even when people learn something and they're like, oh my God, I know how to manifest now. Yes, you have a breakthrough, but in order for you to actually be able to apply that breakthrough and live that breakthrough and not go on autopilot on your past behaviors, that takes months of having a safe space when you can practice. But this is a huge difference between somebody who has a breakthrough and somebody who actually is changing. So I had the breakthrough that, hey, something is not working out. And I know it's about my mindset. I knew it was about something in myself that attracted these people, the situation, the circumstances, but I had no idea what that was. It's like, I know it's kind of me because I know how manifesting kind of works as you create your own reality and all that. But I was like, I don't know how I did that. Like, how did I create this for me? Like, why? Like, I was so confused.
So basically, this is how you came up with this idea of the course, of the training.
Exactly. I realized that there was something missing in my manifesting knowledge. I was like, okay, there's something here that I don't understand yet. There's something here that I need to know more. So I started searching for especially the quantum physics part, not just the manifesting part that we see everywhere. But being an engineer, I think it helped me not only search for that, but also understand that language, because it's so complicated to read papers on quantum physics, because it's just physics language. It's nothing fancy, nothing understandable. So I read like crazy for a couple of months. I took notes. I saw what works and what doesn't. And then I kind of mirrored that with the literature in the manifesting, you know, woo-woo energy, whatever, you know, side of it. So I then matched them together and then it hit me. I was like, fuck, now I know why it didn't work for me. Now I understand how I can make it work for me. I applied it on myself. I had an amazing launch, like not even a month later. And then since that moment, honestly, my whole business has changed. And since that moment, constantly, I'm kind of testing the universe to see, can it be an even easier way to do this? Can we make even more money? Can we make even faster money? Like, how can we play with this? Because it also helps me as a business coach now to tell other people how they can do it faster and easier, not from a marketing perspective, not just from a mindset. So then I put everything that I've had and I've worked on myself in the Manifesting Queen course. So it's all laid out. But the thing is, just because it's all laid out, it doesn't mean it's going to change your life forever. It's only going to change your life forever if you constantly apply it. It's just like learning exercise routine, you know, like, oh, you meet this awesome coach, fitness coach. They show you this awesome exercise routine that you can do every day for 30 minutes or so to get the I don't know, the ideal body in 6 months. And then you do it once or twice in 6 months and you're like, huh, my body is not ideal yet. And I'm like, dude, you know, just because you learn something doesn't mean that it's going to get you the results unless you apply it constantly. And you go deep with yourself, especially in the self-development world, and especially in the manifesting queen, you can do the same lesson every single month and have different ahas. Ain't that right? Because you've been through it, okay, I think.
That's so true. And I have this quote in my head when I hear about this idea, new level, new devil. You always have to grade yourself and you always hit like a ceiling that you will have to work through to break it and to step into your next level.
Exactly. And that can happen very fast for certain people. Like certain people change so fast, they need to go through it again and again and again because they kind of max out their level. They're like, oh, I'm here already. Okay, now new desire. And other people have a more, you know, lighter journey. They can just redo it every 3 months or every 6 months, depending on where they're starting from too. We're not all starting from the same baseline. Certain people have more trauma. Certain people have lived in a household with so many limiting beliefs. So of course you cannot compare, you know, two people like that. You cannot. Because they're all going to start, not to mention where you're coming from, what country, you know, what's the baseline income there? It also matters. So I see a lot of people, and I'm sorry, I'm going to kind of diverge a bit of it, but a lot of people have huge income goals, especially in business, because now we're talking about the business people. And they're like, oh, I want to hit this amount and this amount. And when I ask them, where are you right now? They're like at 10% of, at I think even that's max, like 10% of what they want. And I'm like, can you see the huge difference between what you want and where you are? It's not that it's not possible for you. Of course it's possible for you. But to make this gap smaller, you need to set your goals differently. And I think here is where a lot of people make the mistake, then they get disappointed because month after month, they're not hitting their goals. And they're like, what's wrong with me? I'm not good enough. Their self-esteem plummets, their self-confidence plummets. They don't know what to do to raise that up. They don't have a group or a community to be like, hey, I can go here and just vent about this shitty situation that I'm in that I don't know how to solve. Because if they go and say that to their best friends who might not have a business, usually that's what happened. So they're like, maybe you should just quit. Maybe you should get a job. Maybe business is too hard for you. Maybe you should start another business because I know someone who does I don't know what and they're doing fine. So all this talk actually makes you doubt yourself even more instead of building yourself up because you're like, maybe they're right. Maybe I should quit. Maybe I should do something else.
A lot of negative self-talk. And usually when you're in this situation, when you have a business, there's also this hustle culture that says, oh, you're so far away from your goal. You still have such a long way. Just do more action, more action, more action. Mm-hmm. You mm-hmm. kind of like burn yourself out even more.
Yes, but, yes. And I'm happy that you brought this up, the hustle, because everybody believes, and I'm 100% of this, that if they would work more, they would be able to make more money. Everybody believes that. And they actually blaming themselves, like, see, I didn't work yesterday enough. That's why I'm not making money today. That's why this month I didn't hit my goals. If only I would have talked to 30 more people, or I would have done 3 more videos, I would have written 5 more articles or stuff like that. And by blaming yourself and shaming yourself, because this comes from, you know, I'm shaming myself and I'm being very mean with myself, so I would motivate myself to be better next time. But when you're doing that, you're on a very low energy scale. So you're at shame, you're at guilt, which is the lowest form of vibration. So if you stay there every day, because every day you're beating yourself up for not doing more, you will not manifest your dream goals faster or at all, because you cannot manifest from here something that is here. It's simply not a match to your vibration. So all the time, goals or dreams come super easy to manifest for you if you are at the same frequency as those goals are, which means feeling good most of the time. But if you're beating yourself up, you're not feeling good. You cannot feel good and shame yourself at the same time. So you have to choose which one will you do. But for most people, they cannot do it on autopilot to just feel good about not being good enough. Their natural instinct is to blame themselves, push themselves, motivate themselves, guilt themselves into doing more stuff and more stuff.
Yeah, that's a very tricky situation to be in. And I actually wanted to ask you this because I know a little bit about your background, about your story that you shared from Instagram and social medias. And usually when you're an entrepreneur, it's not always all good, all pink. And of course, certain moments appear, life happens to all of us, and we are sometimes in a low situation and we don't have the energy or the vibration. We don't have such good thoughts. Like, what do you do when you're in this position? How can you manifest even when you're low with your emotions and with your state?
Such another good question. I was actually talking to my husband yesterday. We were revisiting our past years. And from a standpoint of emotion, like looking back, where were we on the scale of consciousness? And I was like, fuck, I was mostly in anxiety all those years and semi-depressed. I'm like, how did I even manifest my goals being so low on, you know, the emotion? Okay, I was like actually surprised that I still manifested not all my goals, but most of my goals, even feeling so low. So I'm going to answer from both scenarios. Can you still manifest certain goals, even if you're in anxiety most of the time or beating yourself up? And how do I do it now when I'm not in that energy anymore? The biggest thing now is the course From Powerless to Powerful, which I use every single day. This is non-negotiable for me. This is not like if I want to do it, like I always want to do it because it makes me feel so good. So it's something that I do every day. And in this course, you get real with yourself. How do I feel today? Usually I do it in the morning. That's the first thing that I do. And then I will do it throughout the day, depending on like when I have like 3 minutes that I'm like bored, I'm like, okay, what do I do now? Like I'm going to do a exercise from that course. So I pinpoint how I feel in the morning, because usually in the morning, you're like either bored or scared or overwhelmed about how many things you have to do that day, or confused, or so many emotions you can have. So I choose one that's more, let's say, descriptive of how I'm feeling. And then I go in the course and I look at the potential exercises I could do to change that energy, to go a little bit up the scale of emotions, which we have a scale of emotion that's like 24 emotions from guilt and shame to enlightenment. So you go up the scale. If I'm feeling shame right now, I'm going to go and look what exercises can I do to feel maybe anger. Anger is better than shame. Or to feel pessimistic is better than being angry. It's better than being in a shame state. So that's what I'm doing. And I'm doing about 30 to an hour of exercises like this. Every day is kind of different. But for example, gratefulness, it's always every day in my routine. And I'm not just grateful about three things. I usually write 30 to 50 things, and they can be real things, like things that happened yesterday or this week or this month or this, I don't know, the last years, or it can also be things that I'm speaking into existence. Like, oh, I'm so grateful that next month this will happen. This is happening for me. Or I'm so grateful that I received this already. So depending on the day, there's not a like five things real and 10 things imaginary. Like it's just like I use my flow. And by doing this practice has allowed me to stay in a alignment state most of the time. Of course, you cannot be in alignment all the time, and that's not the purpose. The purpose is to feel good most of the time. And when you don't feel good, to understand that that moment is so important for giving birth to new desires. So when your business is not making enough money, then you're launching a new desire of, I want my business to make more money. So it's actually good to have those moments, because that's how you're like, who? Or when you have bigger bills in your business because you want to invest in a coach or invest in a program, and you're like, oh, I wish I had more money, you know, because I don't have right now. So you're launching a new desire of, oh, I wish I have more money. And I don't know if it happened to you, but for me, this always happens. When I'm signing up for something that it's kind of scary to pay for, like in business, but because I'm doing it and I'm like, I don't know how, but the universe will have to provide because I'm doing this, so I will need to pay for this. It always happens sometime. Like I always have the money in the end to pay for everything. Even though I don't know today how I will pay for it next month, but I always know that it's somehow I will find the money. Because when we have a priority, like our needs, we always find the money for needs. We're not always going to find the money for wants. That's like depending on, you know, situations. But for needs, like for your rent, your food, your like bills that are very every month, you will always find the money, right?
That's true. That's so true. And I absolutely love as well the gratefulness exercise. I do it as well every day. And I can absolutely share from my own experience how much it helps you to focus, especially in the morning. Because when you start your day with the right set, with the right mindset, your whole day is much better. When you just let things happen to yourself, you're usually so overwhelmed and you end up doing nothing. And speaking of contrasting situations, and from your experience with working with people, which is like the situation that people struggle the most when they start manifesting, which is the point when they start to lose their focus, or maybe they don't have the results they want?
So in business, I think a lot of people get results right away, especially when they join Manifesting Queen or any of my programs right now. And then they have that high. It's like a new high. That you're like, oh my God, I can do this. This happened for me. I'm so excited. And then they don't do anything. Like they don't continue on doing the thing that got them there. And then they come to me like 2 months later, they're in a struggle. Maybe they're not making enough money. Maybe they had something, a big contrasting thing in their life. Like they lost somebody, or they have bad clients or something. They're like, look at me. You know, they feel the same pain as they did 2 months prior. And the reason why this happened is because manifesting works very fast. Everyone, after they learn how to do it, they can manifest really fast. But the change, the everlasting change, is you changing your behavior. And if you're not used, or you don't want to change your behavior, then of course you're going to end up in similar situation over and over and over again. So I always tell people, and this, and you know this because I say this every single month, do the work constantly. And not because you have to do the work, but because the work is helping you change. And by you changing, your life becomes easier. And we all want our life to be easier in the end. But you cannot expect, again, to do 2 push-ups and have amazing body. Like it becomes a way of living. And when you see how easy your life can be, you're like, oh, every morning I just sit for an hour at my desk and I'm being grateful and I'm doing this exercise and that exercise and I'm creating my reality and whatever. And then you see how things actually work out for you. You're like, dude, I want to do this every single day because look how easy and how fast I can change my life. So of course you want, it's not something that you have to do and you're like, oh, no, I have to be grateful. I don't want to be grateful today. It's so hard, you know, like it's not like that. So this is like the biggest thing that I've seen people do. And that's okay too, because if you have the support, then it doesn't matter. Because if you have a group like we have where they're like, come, because we probably saw some people that disappear for like 2-3 months. And then you're like, oh, here they go again. And they start working on the same course. That's because most probably something their life has changed and now they want to manifest again. So they're like, I'm going back to the course. And that's okay too, because they have a safe space where they can share, they can do the exercises. So they will manifest again awesome things. Unfortunately, others who don't have a safe space, who don't have someone to support them, when they are in that hole of, oh my God, I'm in this shitty situation, I don't know what to do, they usually are surrounded by people with a negative mindset. And that is impacting themselves too. So they might stay in that, oh my God, worry, you know, oh my God, this will never work for me. And then you speak with your friend who has another problem, and you speak with another friend who has another problem, and you look at the news and there's so many bad things in the world, and you're like, fuck, you know, everything is bad. I will never be able to do this and all that. And I think the biggest thing we're using manifesting and having a successful business in the end is support. That's the biggest thing, is having a safe space where you can ask questions and you know there will be answered. Like, you know, somebody will see you and hear you and guide you and care for you, who knows how to guide you and not just, you know, like not just, oh, think positive, but actually know how to take you through the pathway and make you feel like your emotions are valid, even if they're shame, they're still valid because some part of you feels that and that's their reality. Like your inner child has that reality, but that reality can change and can be integrated. And I always pinpoint, go to module 2, go to module 3, go to this lesson. And you know, because I'm noticing certain things, I'm like, go do that again, because that's exactly what you need right now. And if you have this, then life is much, much easier, because life is hard anyways. I mean, when you look at it from the outside perspective, there's always bad things happening, but you can live in your own bubble. And you've seen that even in our group, certain people who, like, for example, now in Texas, it's a huge issue. You know, people don't have food, don't have electricity, don't have heating. Like, it's a real, for millions of people, this is their reality. But there are other people who have absolutely no problem in the same environment. And that's what I say, that when you're becoming a manifesting queen, you live in your own bubble where you're so protected of everything else, even if it happens in your neighborhood, even if it happens in your city, you're going to be the only one who doesn't have that problem.
That's so true. And speaking about support, I think I'm super certain about this, and I love it, because that's what I also state in my business as well, that when you want to do a lasting change, it's very important to have like a system, a simple system that you can follow every day, and also a support system as people who motivate you, who go with you through all the steps, because by yourself, the percentage of people who actually succeed is very, very low, like 2 out of 10. So yeah, having people with the same mindset as you, same goals, it's super important, very important for you into achieving everything that you want. Lastly, but not least, I want to ask you, what is now your motivation of doing this? What is your why? Why do you want to help women entrepreneurs succeed and thrive?
So awesome. And actually yesterday I had to answer this, but in a different way. Somebody asked me when will I have kids? That was the question, something like that. Like, are we not ready? I've been married for 5 years. So kind of, you know, it's time. And by answering this question, I actually answered with my purpose. And I said, you know, I love kids. I want to have kids. I want to have a house full of kids. And my husband knows that, he's like, fuck, you're crazy. But I want to have a house full of kids and full of dogs. Like, that's my dream. But that's not my dream now. Because now what I'm motivated, what I really want to do in my life is build a business for myself that allows me all the freedom that I really want. But most importantly, is being an example of what's possible. I never had that growing up. I didn't have an example of what's possible for a woman, where a woman that works a little bit, that has fun in her career, that is helping people, that's making lots of money, that is just helping others. Like, I never had that, you know, growing up, or even in my, like, in my early 20s, I never saw anybody that doing this. So I didn't think that's possible for me. Like, if we don't have examples of what could be possible for us, we cannot create that. It's not possible to create something you don't see elsewhere. So first you need to see it someplace else. As I developed and I worked with more people, like I hired more people to help me out, of course I found more and more mentors to be like, I like this and I like that. So right now I'm actually modeling my business and my life experience based on a mentor that she, you know, got pregnant at 35, I think, and now she's 40 and she has 3 kids already, and she's a millionaire, and she's having the same model business like as I do. So for me, that's what I want to do. Like, business wise, this is my purpose right now. And I know certain women, they want to be moms, like that's their purpose, and that's fine, but that's not mine. Like, for me, mom comes after I fulfill my first dream, if it makes sense. And I think especially now, after you reach a certain age, especially after you're 30, like, you have to choose, like, be a mom or have a business or have an awesome career. And I don't think it's about choosing. I think it's about really embodying what will gonna make you happier, because a child is not a purpose, especially if you're doing it for the wrong reasons. So I think it's so important to know, what do you want? And I want to impact. I want to be an example. I want for women to see that, hey, if it's possible for me, it's possible for them too. Like literally, it's possible for everybody. And if I could do it from this country, if I could do it at this age, if I could do it with this amount of help or this amount of money, then you can too. And if more people see that and learn from me and surround me, because you know how honest I am in the group, like I share everything. I share my ups and downs, I share my desires, and I share when I accomplish them. So it's very, you know, I share my vulnerabilities when things don't work out. So people can see that life is a buffet of events, not just sweet things, but it's also like spicy sometimes, or, you know, it has all sorts of flavors. And that's beautiful, because if you only see the sweetness of life on Instagram, for example, then you tend to believe that if your life is not sweet every day, there must be something wrong with you. And that's not true. And I cannot be super transparent and vulnerable on Instagram, because not everybody has the right to see that side of me. I don't believe we should, you know, be who we really are with everybody. I do believe we need safe spaces where we can all do that in a very safe environment. And that's why I do that in the group. And I talk about all the things. So I think, I don't even know exactly, you know, if I think I digress from the question, but being an example, that's what motivates me. And I want to show and prove for me right now, especially this month, is to show how can I work even less than what I'm working now and make even more money. So right now I'm working on average 1-2 hours a day. That's like my normal schedule. So I want to be like, so for last week's launch, I personally worked for 2 hours, and we made 5 times more money than what we invested in promotion. Next week, I would like to work 30 minutes. So doing the same thing. So that's what I'm saying. I'm always pushing myself to be like, it's like a game. It's like, how can I do that, but with less work or less energy or with less money, and get a bigger return on investment? And also, this is something that I've seen women entrepreneurs struggle with. And I have some examples. Women can make a lot of money, but they are killing themselves in the process. And I've seen an example with an amazing woman, and she's awesome. And she made lots of money in her launches, but the amount of work that she does is
insane.
Like, she works 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day, especially doing launches. Like, it's so hard for her that she needs then a month of break. And I don't believe that that's what we're supposed to do. And I think more and more women are like, you know, I know how to make money, but I don't want to make money that way. And for me, it was the same. At one point, I was making lots of money, but I was working so much. Like, I was coaching every day. I had clients like a couple of hours a day, every single day. So it was like so exhausting. Like, even when I had time, because, you know, let's say you only coach 4 hours a day, but you don't just work 4 hours. Like, energy wise, when you're coaching someone, it's like double the amount of energy that you're actually using per hour. So even though I had like 3 more hours until I would go to sleep, I couldn't do anything because I was wiped. Even watching a movie, I couldn't, because I wasn't paying attention. So I was just getting myself angry that I cannot, you know, pay attention to a movie. I had to just watch, let's say, shows that I've seen before, because those would be relaxing for me to watch. So even that, you know, it seems like, oh my God, really? And yes. And I was like, I don't want to work so much. I want to still make money. I want to still have an impact. I want to still help people, but I don't want to work so much to get there. And for me, through Manifesting Queen and through all my other programs that I teach, this is what I want to show everybody, that it is possible. Finding the right marketing strategy for your business is possible. Working much, much less is possible. But yes, there are some tweaks. There are mindset and manifesting tweaks that you can do, but there are also marketing tweaks that you can do. And that's why I'm always testing things, because how else would I be a good business coach if I wouldn't test all sorts of strategies and then be like, that works, that doesn't work, this works like this. So then I can share with my clients, be like, do this, do that. Like, even last month, I saved one of my clients a couple $100 per month just because I gave you a different opportunities that she had in mind. She was like, oh, I'm using this because I've heard this is the best. And she came with me and I was like, dude, you don't need this. And then I showed her what she doesn't need. We cut a lot of crap out and she's like, oh my God, like, my life is so much simpler now. And it's so much cheaper to do my business now. And I was like, yeah, that's what you're paying me for, to cut the work that's not helping you grow, to cut your expenses that are not important, and save or invest in other things that will actually grow your business. So I hope this made sense.
Totally, and I absolutely love this. Somehow challenging the universe to give you the easiest possible way.
Exactly, exactly, exactly.
More easy. Can it be more fun?
You know, exactly.
Used to always struggle, to always look for the hard way. We just need more easy and more fun in our lives. I want to tell my audience something in the end regarding, because I know you have a special gift for them. You are running a free challenge right now, and they will be able to access the link from the description. Can you tell us just two words about this challenge, how it can help them as well?
Yes, so it's a free workshop. It's for 2 hours, so please bring your notepads because you will be writing stuff where I share exactly how I've grown my business and how I've learned about the new manifesting formula and all that I teach right now. And it's, again, I said 2 hours, it's 3 secrets that are really important for any business women. It's how you can control your reality all the time, how manifesting is 99% of the whole process and 1% is only action or marketing. So that's something that people are like, I don't think that's true. Well, I show them step by step how that's true, because it is true. And that's exactly how I launched this week. I made $6,000 in 24 hours. So again, without a website, without a sales page, without anything, because that's possible, and it's possible for everybody. And I share exactly the same strategy that I've done this week. It's also in the workshop. And actually, depending, I don't know exactly when this will air, but usually sometimes we have live rounds of this workshop where I actually show live and people can ask me questions as I'm teaching, or we have recorded ones. So depending on when you're going to see this, click on the link and see if you can grab the live version or the recorded version, but they're both amazing. It's just that the live version, you can actually ask me questions. So make sure to join live if you can, because I'm not going to do more of those. Because again, I said, you know, I always try to work less and less. So if you happen to catch me live, you must join live. I think that's a better experience, because again, I'm answering questions that people have on the spot, which can be a very, very useful. And because you will join that workshop in the end, if you see what I'm teaching and you love that, you will be able to join me and Miru and all the other awesome women in the Manifesting Queen community, where there's so many bonuses. And I think Miru can say even more how many bonuses we have and how we use them and what the experience is all about.
Yes, fingers crossed for those who will catch the live. They will have a full experience and I'm sure they will enjoy it. And yeah, I can totally share from my experience that the Manifesting Queen has helped me so much understand how manifesting and the law of attraction works. I have been using this for the last 8 years, but I can honestly say that just last year I understood it fully, how and what are the steps to it. And it made me step into my full potential and step into my ideal life right now that I'm
feeling. Isn't it more easier now for you to just know when you're not manifesting as fast as you want, like, why is that happening? So you're not like, I don't know why I'm not manifesting. Like, isn't it empowering to like, yes, I know what I'm not manifesting and I know what I need to do.
It's self-work, excuses, fears. Which one?
And it's like so easy, because I don't know if you even saw in our group, like when people do the exercise and they share and then a week later they're like, oh, I manifested this, or oh, this money came to, or oh, this client showed up. So it's just like so awesome to notice how they're going through the exercise and then boom, they manifest something huge, because it works all the freaking time. Like, it really works all the freaking time. That's why I'm saying module 2, module 3 on repeat every month, and then you can really manifest awesome things every month.
Thank you so much, Roswitha, for taking the time again to have this interview with us and to share from your experience. And I will leave here in the description also your Instagram so people can reach you, they can see your story more in detail, and they can contact you directly. See you next time with a new
story. Thank you.